Hey, Journey Church, it's Eric and Mary Jo here to talk to you today about prayer. We've been taking time each Thursday with different members of our team to talk about this subject and continue to develop a culture of prayer here at Journey Church. We created this Pray First guide. If you don't have one, feel free to grab one the next time you're here at the church, or you could go to journeychurch.org/pray right now and you could have a downloadable copy that you could use to follow along. If you missed any of the episodes, you could go and find any of the previous episodes there as well. And then today we're picking up and page 8 of our guide, and we've really been trying to set a framework for prayer, really not telling us exactly how to pray, but using, in this case, the Lord's Prayer as a bit of a model prayer to help us in our own prayer life. So today we reach the part of the Lord's Prayer where it says, "Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven." So I want to talk a little bit about the corporate aspect of that prayer, and then Mary Jo might talk a little bit about putting it to work in our personal lives and making the kingdom of God our primary concern.
Yes.
So when I think about this one, especially in light of what we're experiencing right now, we don't have to put our faith and our confidence in the politics of this world. Amen. We don't have to worry about those kinds of things. We can put our faith and trust in the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, who is supreme over all. So ultimately, it's God's plans that are going to prevail in our own lives personally, but also corporately in the current events that we see out there in the world. So when we pray, we can pray kind of both of those directions. We can pray for ourselves personally and what's going on in our own lives.
Absolutely.
But we can also pray for our country and the leaders of our country and say, "Lord, would you move on their hearts?
Amen.
Would you give them wisdom? Would you help them?
Right.
Would your kingdom be fulfilled in the midst of all of these challenges that we see?" And sometimes that seems to happen a lot slower than I would like personally. I don't know about you. And things certainly seem to get crazier and crazier out there as each week goes by. And the devil may win a few battles, but let me tell you something, the Lord is going to win the war.
That's right.
So I know you wanted to talk a little bit maybe about Luke 12:31 that goes in alignment with what we're talking about today. What are your thoughts, honey?
Well, it says in Luke 12:31, it says, "He will always give you all you need from day to day if you will make the kingdom of God your primary concern." And it's kind of funny because I use that in my altar on Sunday because it's just been on my heart constantly. How do we continue to live in this world so opposite of God's word, but still make God your primary concern when everything else is coming in at you? And I know you've heard Pastor Eric say this because it's been one of my kicks lately that I had learned and heard someone said, kingdom over culture. And just in everyday walk, I need to say that to myself several times throughout the day. Kingdom over our culture is just a clear line. It's not black or it's black or white, not gray. And so that has just really been helping me make God my primary concern, his ways, his word. And obviously we know that by reading his word, by being in community with other believers who believe like we do, who want to live a holy, set apart life in a world that's like just throwing anything yucky at us, you know? So I don't know. I'm excited that we're doing this, that a lot of people, I'm learning more and more, don't know how to pray. They make it hard. They read 10 ways to God hear, you know, have God hear your prayers. In reality, it's just conversation with the Lord. I do believe there's different, you know, authorities you can take up, and your prayers can have more power when you're using scripture in them. And just like this book is sharing and showing us, it's the Lord's Prayer. How did he, his example of how we're to pray. And so this is just fun doing this. And I just love that. That's the same exact scripture I had on Sunday.
In the same vein, I think of Matthew 6 is it starts out and it says, pray, fast, give. And then he goes through a litany of concerns that we have as human beings. Where's our clothes going to come from? How are we going to feed ourselves? How are we going to have a roof over our head? And then it also concludes with a very similar set of words where it says, you know, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Some sections of scriptures also translate that with the same words, make the kingdom of God your primary concern.
Yep.
And I think that's what we've always tried to do, is put the kingdom first. So in a very practical sense, how do we live in a kingdom first first way. So the book gives you a couple tips there. You know, be about what God is about. Seeking and saving that which is lost. Making a difference in the lives of others in Jesus' name. Sharing the gospel and our lives with other people. So it spans well beyond prayer into the practicality of our own lives and how we live. But we bring the kingdom to earth wherever we find ourselves. So how are we imaging God? How are we representing him when we're out there in the world? So we can pray that his will would be accomplished. And actually, his will is going to be accomplished whether we like it or not. So even in our own staff meeting this morning, not really even thinking about this, part of my prayer is always for our church, Lord. Many are the plans of a man, but it's the Lord's plans that will prevail. Mm-hmm. That if we've got things personally or corporately as a church that we're making plans for, I pray that first that it would be in alignment with God's will, that God would reveal his will to us, and then from there we could move forward. Any other thoughts that you have from what we've been talking about so far?
I was just thinking as you were saying that, that is all how we bring heaven to earth, right, is through our prayers. But earth and the people in it need to see our faith. They need to see our prayers. They need to see us being powerful. Our neighbors know that we go to church on Sunday, but do they see it as we're living out our life, living next door to them? Our coworkers, I guess we need to just challenge people that the kingdom and doing God's will and living for him is something that we should I know it's obvious that we should constantly be doing this, but a lot of people don't know how and they aren't doing it. Our family, our unsaved members, they need to see us being strong believers, Christians that, you know, the first thing we do is we pray. When we go to bed at night, we pray. We pray over our meals. I mean, I know we basically pray throughout our whole day. I mean, it sounds silly, but, as we're thinking, as we're seeing some, Lord, take care of that, you know, always asking him in those conversations. And then there's time for warfare, you know, intercession, deliverance. There's so much different types of prayer. And as believers, I really believe that we need to get going. You know, we need to really be practicing this, being in your devotions. I just think it's so funny that when you do that, he confirms it. He gives you confirmation. I read that scripture on Saturday. I used it on Sunday. And then here it is on Tuesday. Yep. And he just constantly reveals things to us when we're in his word and we're trying to live and make him first and our primary concern.
And I love that we even keep saying first, first, first. More often than not, when I get myself into trouble with things, is if I get ahead of God and I try to do something on my own and I try to bring forth my ideas. And sometimes I think that's our natural inclination. We go out there and we try to accomplish things on our own. But as the guide says, might we pray first and then ask God to reveal to us what we should be doing. And then in great wisdom, we can move forward from
that. And I think that's why this is so, I think a lot of us know that. But we need to be being around people, hearing this message, and just knowing that we're always growing. We all know to live a God first life, but how do you do that? I'm not a procrastinator. I like to get things done. I like to be on point. I know what we're doing at Christmas. I know I have a plan for our church next Easter. I'm always ready. But because he made me that way, I'm just always a thinker and always a planner. I have to say, Lord, did you want this? You know, so that's been my thing, my personal hard thing. I am a go-getter.
Well, he works in our plans in the future as well as the present.
No, I know he does, but I take some steps without him quite often, and this is just a good reminder for myself, you know?
Amen.
Pray first.
Well, why don't we close in prayer?
Amen.
You want to take... She's the real prayer warrior, folks, not me. She's going to pray us out.
All right, let's pray. Also, though, at the end of each of these, there is a prayer. So if you're not comfortable or confident or want to just learn how to hone into exactly pray what it's asking, this book is very good.
Yeah. It's a good
All right.
help.
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, we just come before you right now, Father God, and we are just so thankful for who you are in our lives. We thank you for taking the blinders off of our eyes, Father God, for setting us on a solid foundation of who you are and what you're asking us to do, Lord. This prayer guide is tools for our toolbox, Father God. If we even just follow along in this for the duration to finish the book, Father God, our lives could be turned upside down. So we just ask that your Holy Spirit comes in. Lord, do with us as you will, Father God. Just have us be people who are quick to discern, quick to listen, quick to ask you first, Father God, to be obedient when you do speak to us, Father God. Open up our eyes to see, Lord Jesus, that your ways are way better than our ways, that you order our steps, Father God. So we just trust you in that. We thank you for this day. We thank you for this time to just be able to share our hearts on prayer. Prayer is our love language to you, Father God. It's our communication to you, and you do speak to our hearts, and you do open doors that only you can open, Father God. So we just thank you for being our very, very best friend, Father God. We just ask that you help us to be on purpose in our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray, and we all say amen.
Amen. So journey, as you go about the rest of your week, remember, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And for us personally, would we make the kingdom of God our primary concern? God bless you guys.
Amen.
Have a great day.